Duckbill scissors such as this can be useful tools when you are trimming seams on custom-made bras. This is a muslin trial custom bra designed to verify the fit of the initial patterns, and it's very important that the seams lay as flat as possible. You don't want unnecessary puckers, and so you want to trim the seams down to the closest possible configuration. When I first saw these duckbill scissors, I immediately assumed that they were for right-handed sewers because of the placement of the curved blade. If you're left-handed and you're trying to trim the seam, this isn't really going to do you much good. Then I realized, having gotten a pair to try for myself, if you simply switch it around, then it is correctly, it will work for a left-handed sewer. This is a example of like an applique that I'm going to show you how the duckbill is designed to work with applique. The idea here is that the duckbill side of the scissor can slip under the fabric and raise it slightly so that, and notice how also the handle is raised. It's actually raised off. It's not flat. So we can hold the duckbill flat and push the duckbill blade against the stitching, because with applique you want to cut the excess fabric off, but you don't want to cut the stitching. And that is the function of a duckbill scissor. Now, when you're getting to a custom bra, this is a bra cup, and I've used contrasting black stitching on the white muslin. It's a good idea to test your patterns in muslin before you make regular bras, because once the pattern is correct, you can spend more time in the actual sewing of the final garment. And so this muslin cup is designed to verify the fit. And once again here, now the idea, because we've got a contoured shape here, what we need to do is to put our hand underneath and let your fingers rest on that duckbill blade as you trim off. As you can see, this is a woven fabric, which I recommend is a good thing for bra cups for optimum support. And of course, you can trim off what you don't need. And the idea here is we're trying to get that seam allowance close to that stitching to minimize any kind of fluffiness that might occur if you don't do that. You can do the same kind of trimming with standard scissors. I like these small scale standard scissors. It's just that one of the things that can happen, and it has happened to me on occasion, you actually cut the good side of the fabric so that you have a hole through the entire cup, which of course is not desirable, and you have to remake the cup. The duckbill scissors just gives you that extra little platform so that you can hold the seam close to the stitching . And this is a very nice version of the duckbill scissors that actually is a ginger scissor. I've been using ginger scissors for sewing since the 70s, so I know they do a really quality scissor. And that's the story with using a duckbill scissor.